So then, Abbo, a scoreline, very, very comprehensive scoreline, but actually quite a difficult performance in some respects for the team today.
The scoreline flats did save a little bit because we huffed and puffed and never really controlled the game. The game was never in complete control. We were dangerous on the break and obviously quite clinical in front of goal today. But as I say, we huffed and puffed a little bit and didn't have the control in the game that I would have liked. Didn't string things together as well as we would like and defended a little lackadaisically to concede. So positives, you know, 8 goals and 3 points up and it looks okay on paper. It's a confidence builder for us and we're up and running in the league really.
But we can be far better and we'll have to be far better this week in the 2 games we've got coming up.
A word on the front three today. Obviously, 6 goals between Marco and Luke, but also ably assisted by Javi, who was named Supporters Man of the Match as well.
Yeah, as I say, well, I think that was what we were all about today. Was our forward play. As I say, when we break with conviction, and we look clinical today when we got around the box. So those three deserve all the plaudits and we'll obviously take them today. And obviously ably supported by Sean as well at the point of our midfield. We look good going forward and uncharacteristically we weren't great defensively, so I don't have any real long-term concerns over that. I think that the two things combined when we get them both right at the same time, the signs are good moving forward.
To score after 35 seconds is a great boost, but in some respects that can have an adverse effect on the focus of the players at times.
Yeah, you can score too soon, can't you? Because especially us, because we're kind of better when things are on a bit of a knife edge. So I don't know. We kind of set out and approached the game wanting to kind of control the game and get the ball, get the ball moving for us, and we did that and then scored off our first break and bit of possession. It was a great move, great goal, but then. The kind of the game plan goes out the window then for us as well as them. So can you score too soon? I don't know. Maybe we did today.
We can't conclude this interview without talking about midweek FA Cup progress for the team in a very, very entertaining 180 minutes against Walsall Wood.
Yeah, well, unfortunately I missed the first 90 with work commitments. I was really upset about that, and the reports I had made me very proud of the players and what they obviously put into a difficult shift here with 10 men. Deserved to at the very least take the game to replay. My understanding is that we probably shaded the first encounter and would have deserved to have gone through on that occasion anyway. And then Tuesday night, I just thought the lads were absolutely superb. I thought we started on the front foot. I thought we looked the better side early stages. Got the goal. No surprise that Walsall Wood came back at us and showed their class a little bit early stage of the second half. But we felt we could take the game deep and they perhaps didn't have the conditioning to match ours as the game wore on, and that proved to be the case again. And the two late goals, no more than we deserved. And I think across the two games, we've definitely got the better side and deserve to go through in the top.
Even at this early stage of the season, only a few games in, the conditioning of the players from pre-season is really starting to show. It seems quite evident on a match day.
Yeah, we are a fit group, and Matt Hart and Tomo and Simon between them have got the lads in great shape in the summer, and that we obviously want to maintain that now through the season and make our pre-season work for us right through the season. That's the basis for our season being a successful one. It stood us in good stead, and nobody's looked fitter than us, and I'll be surprised if anybody does. I think it's a big building block for the way we play, the way we want to play.
Couple of new names on the bench today, Rico Taylor and Jake Brown. Rico made it onto the pitch today. First impressions on his performance?
Rico's a very good player. He's somebody that we know a lot about. Simon had him as a youngster, hence he played in the same side as Alex Morrison and Asa Wright, and was about the first team at Hensford a little bit. He's probably had too many clubs a little bit, like Dequan, and maybe needs to find a home and settle down. He's been at Tamworth and Alvechurch. He's been at Redditch. He's had some really good clubs. Very good player. We were a little light in the squad today, and I saw an opportunity to talk to two players who are obviously available, and they've come in, and gives us a chance to have a look at them, and them to have a look at us, and we'll decide on the long term in the next week or so. We're both lads.
Now we cast our mind towards Tuesday night.
I expect a tough game. I expect a tense game. I think that it will be tightly contested. I think that they will put a lot on us. They've got a front three which is big in size, quite direct, and they'll test us. But you know, if our defenders are kind of made for anything really that plays into their hands, for me it's that. And I think Walsall Wood did a little bit of that when they were chasing the game later on, and it suited us. So I'm hopeful that we'll adapt to what Lichfield do on Tuesday, and I think that we can cause them problems, just like we can cause anybody problems. You know, in our attacking third. So I think it'll be tight, and I think it's going to be interesting, and I think it will have a huge sway on our season, because you know, a win for us will really set us off quite nicely.
Cheers, Abbo, well done today.
Cheers, thanks.